Hello dear students, welcome back to the English grammar class. In this class we are going to learn about the proper noun. Okay, what is a proper noun? The special name given to a particular person, place or thing are called proper noun. What do you mean by this? The special name. What do you mean by the special name? Yes, what is your name? Yeah, the name given for a boy, girl, okay, any person, okay, that type of names are called proper nouns. Okay, not only a person's name, it belongs to places' names also or things' names also we can say. So, the proper noun is nothing but the special name given to a particular person, place or thing are called proper nouns. These proper nouns always begins with the capital letters. The proper nouns always begin with the capital letter, and like the names of people, countries, oceans, cities, towns, then the months of the year also begins with the capital letter. The days of the week also begins with the capital letter. Not only like this, countries and ocean, like villages, cities, towns, these also should begin with the capital letters. Those type of names are called proper nouns. Understood, children? Now, what is the proper noun here? The special name given to a particular person, place or thing are called proper nouns. Got it? So, the proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Okay, like the days of the week I told you, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Are there, no? How many days are there in a week? Yes, 7 days are there in a week. How you are going to write the Sunday, Monday? Not small. The capital letter should be a, sorry, the starting letter should be a capital letter. Like Sunday, if you are going to write, S should be in the capital letter. If you are going to write the Monday, M should be in a capital letter. Okay, we have discussed about the proper nouns in the previous class also. So let us go to the activity now. Okay, in your textbook, the first name is rewrite the following sentences using capital letters for proper nouns. So we have to rewrite the sentences. We have to rewrite the sentences using capital letters. Where you should use the capital letter? Only in the place of proper nouns you are going to use the capital letter. Okay? So here the first question is, Lata, Vibha and Gauri went to market. Lata, Vibha and Gauri went to market. So here, which is the proper noun? Can you find out? Yes, children. Yeah, Lata. See here, small letters they have given. Lata is the name of a person. It is a special name given to a person. Okay? Vibha. Vibha is also name of the person. Okay? Then Gauri. Gauri is a special name given to a person. So these are the special names given to a person, particular person. So these are proper nouns. So what we have to do, we want to rewrite these names to the capital letters. Okay, these are called proper nouns, right? Particular names. Okay, these are the proper nouns. So these proper nouns we are going to write in the capital letters. As I told you that, see, proper noun always begins with the capital letter. Okay, you can observe here, you can see here, what it is written in the capital letter, the starting letter, no, here, no, here, no, that means this one is not written in the capital letters, but it is a proper noun. So, these proper noun we want to rewrite. So, starting letter capital. See, Lata, L is capital, Vibha, V is capital and Gauri, G is capital. So, so that we are going to rewrite the sentence as Lata, Vibha and Gauri went to market. Okay, understood children? Let me explain once again. Okay, in this sentence the proper noun is written in the small letter. So proper noun, that is Lata, Vibha and Gauri. These are the special names given to a person. Okay, this we want to rewrite in the capital letter, starting letter, capital letter, we want to rewrite the sentence. Okay, not all, only we have to change the proper nouns here. Okay, so that is Lata, Vibha and Gauri, the starting letter we are going to change. See, this L as capital L, V as capital V and G as capital V. Got it? Others, these are not a proper noun. So it is a sentence. So Lata, Vibha and Gauri went to market. We have done with this. Okay, this is finished. Let us go for the second question now. Kolkata is located on the banks of the river Ganga. So let us find out which are the proper nouns present here. Okay, so here when you are reading the sentence, you can see the Kolkata is located on the banks of the river Ganga. So here Kolkata is a what? It is a place. Kolkata is a place. So for that particular name they have given, that is a special name is Kolkata. So this is a proper noun. Okay, is located on the banks of the river Ganga. Again you can see a proper noun, Ganga. Ganga is the name of the river. Okay, not the name of the person. See, banks of the river, river they are mentioning. So river Ganga, so the Ganga is the name of the river, that is a place. Okay, Kolkata is also place, river Ganga also. So we have to rewrite these into a capital letter. Okay, see here the answer is Kolkata, this K starting letter capital, I'm going to write here K capital K. So that means Kolkata is located on the banks of the river Ganga. See here Ganga G, I'm going to write as capital G. These both are proper nouns. These proper nouns we are going to write in the capital. Okay, once again shall we read this? Say, Kolkata is located on the banks of the river Ganga. Got it, children? Yes. Now, shall we second also finish? Shall we move on to the third question? That is, Amber and Meena went to Agra to visit the Taj Mahal. Who went to Agra here? Amber and Meena went to Agra. Agra is a place to visit the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal also what? What? It is a famous building, right? Yes, no? Famous building it is, Taj Mahal. Have you seen the Taj Mahal? Yes. So, Taj Mahal also a place, that is the proper noun. Agra, proper noun. Amber and Meena, these both belong to the person. Amber and Meena, name of the person it is. Okay, special names. Amber, Meena, Agra, Taj Mahal. These are the proper nouns we can see in the third question. Okay, let us change now. Amber, Meena, Agra is a place, Taj Mahal is a place. Okay, these are the special names also. So what we are going to do here, we are going to change Amber, A as the capital, Amber, special name, particular name of a person, Meena, particular name of a person, went to Agra, particular name of a place, to visit the Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal also particular name of the place. Okay, so here we are going to change A, Meena M, Agra A, Taj Mahal T. These for the capital letters. Got it? Understood, children? Yes. So the third one, son, is let us move for the fourth question. Let us move for the fourth question. That is, December is the last month of the year. December is the last month of the year. Okay? Here, as I told you before, that months of the year also proper nouns. Okay? Months of the year also proper nouns. Like January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. These are the months of the year, right? So these are also proper nouns. So here we can see the December. So December is the last month of the year. So that means this December, D is a proper noun. December is a proper noun. So let us change this December for capital letter. Okay. So here D is capital. So proper noun always begins with the capital letter. So December D, I am writing to the capital letter. Okay. Then we want to rewrite the sentences as it is. December is the last month of the year. Okay. Got it, children? Next, fifth question. Jawaharlal Nehru was a great leader. Jawaharlal Nehru was a great leader. Okay, here Jawaharlal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru is a proper noun. Jawaharlal Nehru is a proper noun. Okay. So I am going to rewrite J as capital, Jawaharlal Nehru, N as capital, was a great leader as it is. So this sentence again I am going to rewrite, okay, using capital letters. Not all, everything we are not writing in the capital letters, only in the place of proper nouns we are going to change. Okay, see, in all the sentences I am not writing the capital. See, this A I am not writing in the capital. It's not so many letters, you can see. So this we are not writing in the capitals. Why? Because those are not proper nouns. Only in the place of proper nouns we are going to write the capital letter. Understood, children? Any doubts in that? No. Okay, next let us move on to the next main noun. Okay. Yes, children. Now let us move on to the next main. That is, answer the following questions. Okay. What is the first question in this? Write the names of two Indian rivers. So you have to write the names of two Indian rivers. So which are the two Indian rivers? We can write here. That is Brahmaputra and Godavari. These are the two Indian rivers we are going to write. Okay. So when you are writing two Indian rivers, so as I told you that rivers also are proper noun. Okay. So Brahmaputra and Godavari, these both are proper noun. So what we are doing here, Brahmaputra B, we are starting with the capital letters. Brahmaputra, G, Godavari. G with the capital letter. Okay. Okay. Next question. Write the names of four Indian cities. You have to write the names of four Indian cities. Okay. So which are the four Indian cities here? Mumbai, proper noun. Delhi, proper noun. Bangladesh, sorry, Bangalore, proper noun. Hyderabad, proper noun. These are the names of the cities. Okay, names of the Indian cities. Got it? So Mumbai, Delhi, Bangalore and Hyderabad. So these are proper nouns. Okay, these are the special names given to a place. Particular names we can say. Okay, these are the particular names given to a place. So these are called proper nouns. So that means names of the cities also proper nouns. Names of the rivers also proper noun. Okay, next. The third question is, write the names of four famous buildings in India. You have to write the names of four, any four famous buildings of India. Which are the four famous buildings you can say in India? That is Taj Mahal, Qutub Minar, Golden Temple, Gateway of India. These are the four famous buildings you can see in India. So here by this word we are understanding famous buildings also a proper noun. Not famous buildings, the names of the famous buildings. As I told you, Taj Mahal, Qutub Minar, Golden Temple, Gateway of India. These are the names of the famous buildings. So the names of the famous buildings also proper noun. Got it? Next, write the names of any five countries and their languages. Okay, what they are asking the question, you have to write the names of any five countries' names you have to write. Which is our country? India. Right? So like that, you have to write any five countries. Okay, there are so many countries, right? So in that, any five you want to write, with that, which language they are going to speak. That also you should write. So the four countries' names are Canada, Germany, Italy, India, Turkey. Okay, these are the five countries' names I have written. Okay, these are the five countries. Which are they? Canada, Germany, Italy, India and Turkey. I have written five countries' names. Okay, so which language they will speak there? In Canada, they are going to speak French. French also they will speak, English also they will speak, children. Okay, in Canada, French language. In Germany, German language. Okay, in Italy, Italian language. In India, Hindi also we will speak, English also we are going to speak. Next, in Turkey, Turkish language. These are the languages they are speaking. Got it? By this, we will come to know that names of the countries and the names of the languages also proper noun. Okay? Yes. Next, we'll move for the fifth question. That is, write the names of two religious books. You have to write the names of two religious books. Which was our religious books? You know, no? Ramayana, Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad. These are our religious books. So we have to write only two religious books. I have written that Vedas and Upanishads. Okay, Vedas and Upanishads are our religious books. Okay, that means these religious books also having the special names. The book is having special name, no? Vedas, Upanishads. So like this, it also belongs to the proper noun. Okay, next, write the names of months of the year. You have to write the names of months of the year. So as I told you, the month which are they also I told. So you have to write the names of the month of the year in the capital. Starting letter you should write in the capital. See, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. Okay, so here we have written the names of the months of the year. So this also we should write in the capital letter so that this also all proper noun. Okay, I think you have understood with this. So let us revise once. Names of the river are the proper nouns. Names of the current cities also proper nouns. Names of the famous buildings proper nouns. Then countries, names of the countries and their language proper nouns. Then religious books, names of the religious books proper nouns. Then the names of the months of the year also proper nouns. Got it? Yes, next. Shall we move to next meaning? Yes, children. Now let us move on to the next meaning, that is underline the proper noun. In this sentence, you are going to underline the proper noun. Let us see which one is the proper noun now. First, read the sentence. December is the coldest month in our country. So, once again, shall we read the question? Yes. December is the coldest month in our country. So which is the proper noun here? Which is the proper noun? Name of the month. Which is the name of the month here? Yes, December. So December we have to underline. So December is the coldest month in our country. December is the proper noun. Okay, the second question. Sunita has a lovely doll. Sunita has a lovely doll. Which is the proper noun in the sentence? Sunita. Why Sunita? Because it is a particular name of the person. That is special name of a person. Okay, so Sunita is proper noun. So we are going to underline the Sunita. Sunita has a lovely doll. Got it? Yes. Next, Mr. Chopra is a doctor. Mr. Chopra is a doctor. So which is the proper noun here? Mr. Chopra. Right? Mr. Chopra is proper noun, right? How? Because it is a special name of a person. So it is a proper noun. Okay, next. Ruby loves bananas. Ruby loves bananas. So here the proper noun is Ruby. Because it is also a particular name of a person. Okay, next. Who is your English teacher? Who is your English teacher? Which is the proper noun here? See and say me, which is the proper noun? Yes, English is a particular subject. Particular name of the subject is English. So English is a proper noun. Okay children, now you have underlined the nouns part, proper nouns part. Now let us see which is the common noun in this. So underline the proper noun and you have to circle the common noun. Here only you can circle the common noun. We'll see how you are going to find out. Circle the common noun in this. Common noun is naming words. As no name of a place, animal, thing, as I told you in the previous class. So let us find out the common nouns also in this. So December is a proper noun. It is a particular name. So this December is the coldest month in our country. Country is a what? Common noun. So what you have to write? Circle the country. Country is a common noun. Okay. Next, second one. Sunita has a lovely doll. Sunita has a lovely doll. Sunita, as we told you, that is the proper noun. So this is the common noun here. Doll. Why? Because it is a thing. Person, place, animal or thing, you have to circle here. Okay, don't get confusion. Particular names means proper noun. Common names, common place, common name, common person, common thing. These are common. Okay, common noun. So doll is a thing. So we are going to circle for the common noun. Next, Mr. Chopra is proper noun. We have finished with that. Person, person, doctor is a person. So here we are going to circle the common noun. What? Next, Ruby loves bananas. Ruby loves bananas. Okay, Ruby is a particular name. Banana is the thing which you are going to eat. Considered as thing. Okay, next, who is your English teacher? So English is a particular name. So that is a proper noun. So teacher common. Teacher is a common noun. So we are going to circle this. Understood, children? Any doubts in this? No. Okay. Let us move on to the next main. That is, you have to match the countries with their people. You are going to match it. You can see the F main in your book. F main, here they have given the country's name. Here they are given the people's name. Okay, what we call for the people. Okay, so we can match it now. See, what is the first question you are having? America. America is a country. So the people's called as Americans. Okay, you can see here. See properly and match it. America, American. Next, India, Indian. China, people called Chinese. Japan, Japan is a country. Japanese or people name, people. Japan, Japanese. Egypt, Egyptian. Match it. Arabia, Arabian. Nepal, Nepali. Next, Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan. Korea, Korean. Thailand, Thai. Italy, Italian. Pakistan, Pakistani. Okay, so we have to match the country with their people. Okay, children, finish? Okay. I think you understood the proper nouns. Children, if any doubts, you can ask. Yes, I hope you understood. Let us meet on the next class. Thank you.